So in the studio today, I have Aart and Minaj.
Nikki stole my last name.
And you guys are a management client relationship duo?
Sometimes. I'd like to think more of myself as just an artist.
He's amazing. Yeah.
It's really easy. Everything's like everything I do is kind of like, I'm like a mother to a baby. Which, actually, thank you for bringing that up. Why did we have to hire a babysitter tonight? We don't have a baby.
I don't know why you're bringing this up right now.
Do you have a child?
I don't have time to write songs right now.
I mean, I'm his manager, so I'm like planning his future. So, like, this is what we need to be doing.
Is this what you do for all of your...
We just need practice, you know. We just, like...
Practice for what?
The future.
So you guys don't...
Us.
I'm sorry. Let's get to the music. So, Aart, you're a musician.
How many of my songs have you heard?
Charlie Brown.
I've got this one whole track that is literally just typing on a keyboard for about 30 minutes. Have you ever heard of, What's the name? Oh, Bonnaroo?
Yes.
I played main stage there about 2 years ago, and then this, again, I'm playing this year upcoming, but I played like in the middle of the night. The light show was incredible, but for that song specifically,
mm-hmm. It's pretty obvious. He's on the track for platinum.
I used to have these beautiful, they were beautiful, 3 foot long, just spiral nails. I always kept them painted blue and orange. I love that color scheme. I had them rested. I don't drive. I couldn't drive with those bad boys.
Right.
I had them rested on the seat beside me. Minaj slides in, just...
You know I was on the phone.
And that was just the one fingernail. Nine more...
That... Sounds tragic.
Now you got me all sad again because I'm thinking about my fingernails.
So to get it right, the sound was...
We're at 3 and there was 7 more, and I'm going to spare the details because I'm about to cry.
Gotcha.
I have to, like, plan all of his stuff.
They're voicemails. They're not calls. They're voicemails. They're your voicemails.
No.
You're the only one who calls me. That's not true. Girls call me.
And if they do, I call them back, and I tell them, call them again, and I'll slit your throat.
So you guys seem like you're going through a bit of a rough patch. I'm sorry. That
if you're saying not perfect and probably not going to work out, then you fingernailed it.
You son of a gun! I thought we were going so great. Mm. I think we are.
Bye.
We just, it's a rough patch, you know? Everyone has them.
I had a drink. At around 7 a.m. and continued having those drinks until said...
I mean, mimosas are just so good in the morning, you know?
Really good mimosas.
You gotta get
mimosas.
The vitamin C.
What you do is you just take you take a little mimosa glass, which is your standard margarita cup, and you just pour... You fill it up about halfway with just whiskey.
It's just whiskey in a margarita glass?
I had about 12. You want to talk about music? I really get into making... Well, you know what? The music takes a back seat when I'm drinking, because I'm making a cookbook.
So you're making a cookbook?
I'm making a cookbook. It's like you were...
I mean, I tried talking to Food Network to get him a show.
Right.
But they wanted to see, like, a demo. And, like, I tried to get him to go in the kitchen, but he refused.
I've never actually cooked, but I think that I have a really good palate in the sense that I can maybe, like, half a teaspoon of nutmeg, maybe a cup of cumin, and next thing you know, you chop up a little bit of basil. I don't know. There it is. That's one of them. You get, like, a big old thing for, like, six.
What, do you get one f***ing piece of basil?